or any I-11 of your choice. For instant JY, CADC forward, look like immediately after CAing the JY, get out of that astonished range with the dash forward and go for the anti-air.
Yeah, definitely. I've been trying to work on that myself. But into the match here, we have Surfsquad on Scissor, which I can't say I expected. Maybe there was something. Did he run Scissor?
He did run Scissor last monthly, and I do believe the monthly before that. It is certainly one of his long-held pockets. He doesn't pull it out too often there in Nebraska, but I have been seeing it more often.
I wonder if it's because the Pikachu and Mirror matchup is just.
It's like, okay, Pikachu is one of those. They kind of have slightly more damage.
Mm-hmm.
It's like moderate, but what Pikachu's real threat is just the amount of frame traps that are built into its moves, through mids, and the meter. Once Pikachu gets meter, it's nasty. Plus, like, the damage buff. Okay, I'm trying to go for that enemy attack behind those swords there. Awesome. Going for a shield break, maybe? Get a Snivy call.
Oh, yo! That was risky. That Snivy could have easily busted that. Oh my gosh. Almost taking it, too. Gotta throw at that burst.
Yeah, with Pikachu's recent buffs, Pikachu has all the movement tools to just not deal with Gengar, especially not only the frame trap, but especially stall, because Pikachu can just stall themselves.
Yeah, that's true. Really good spacing there from Surfsquad on that transition from field to duel.
For those sword Okies, straight off of the knockout.
Good work, Bunner.
That spark, no grab pitch from Surfsquad, however.
I think he's committed to the CBC, I don't think he's going to
that castle.
Yeah. Okay,
Surfsquad with the maximum conversion. Gotta watch out for that spark. No amount of funky grab will work against that.
Playing it safe at range.
Getting that ticker middle claw. Okay, no respect for this bird. Yora quickly running out. She does have Snivy, but the moment that she does call it, her spike can very well just pull out first. And be like, yeah.
Oh!
There it is.
Alright, so that's really good adaptation there. Seeing that she was going for the counterattack every time, just popping the combo and going for the merge confirm. Really, really well played. Oh, not able to space that one just barely. New turn. What's now?
Like in the good use of hover dash there, just. Keep it that mid-range spacing that Caesar is so good at keeping.
Can he upper stance through Pikachu's 5-8? The ground ball?
I'm not too sure.
It's projectile.
Okay, so he is, but it's a fairly strong one, that's it.
Yeah. Hmm. Let's see if he comes up here or not. Ooh, get rid of the safest.
Either way, Surfsquad is better off. Like, CADC saying that for a reason. He loves having that meter. Especially when versus Pikachu, you know, Pikachu just builds meter automatically. So having that burst tested is ultra important.
Definitely.
Conversion, not quite enough to finish it off though. Surfsquad sitting on that Snivy. Dangerous.
Yeah.
But the homing straight out from the corner. He was feeling the pressure. He made a good call right there as Fiora went in for the grab.
Alright, Spud up a game here.
Taking a sports bet is always a tough choice, isn't it?
You're going for a change of some sort.
Change of support. Change support and cheer, even if you win. End the rule. End the rules.
How did he run the last round? I don't remember what he ran the last round.
He ran Snivy.
Was he running Snivy?
So, okay, you're seeing a lot of these nice CADCs around, just kind of forcing your way in, trying to go for that frame travel against SCA, but it does have rather large damage and fast activation. See, he does have that Swords Dance up, he's missing that middle throw. There it is. Look at that open grab, no dice. Or coming out with the people in the island shell, going for that OP grab. Up.
Oh! Nice. Nuzzle.
No, not nuzzle.
Oh! That's unfortunate.
You called that out with that early time fire wise, trying to take it out.
Ooh! Really good cancel on the sword stance. Grab working that little too. This dude just running out the corner. He's going for the grab.
Putting the fear of Arceus into Pikachu right now. First Bud is holding on to burst. Not really. Okay, there it is. That was enough to press him to use it. He does have to close his health scene though. The timing's
got him.
You're feeling out that. At that time, anticipating that metal call, because once Caesar does that, he is plus. That just leaves him able to do all sorts of mix-ups out of. So I really enjoy that call out.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh. That shield drop. Nice moment from Fiora, getting yourself up the corner, putting yourself back in another one, however. Just by putting that pressure back.
Trying to stay out of the corner with his movement.
Nice. Nice crack pushing too. He's got that corner. Brad, Fiora's sitting on 10 meter. Mulga too, but I'm not. I wonder why he's not using Mulga to punish all these other guys.
Everdash can actually get rid of the Mulga.
Does it?
Yep. Which is kind of surprising why she's running it. I mean, you could catch a counterattack, like, because you wouldn't be able to start that. Win a crit, too! It's not early enough. You got no reason not to burst. Ooh! Ooh! Real good!
Oh,
it's in there, man. Didn't even need the burst. Didn't even need the burst. Oh my gosh.
Even if she attempted to back out or jump, that exhaust was what Hester had. Like, the moment she... There, she had, like, a couple frames and shield. No other time to get out.
Look at that, too. She got the burst nugget and one field, and already just one tick away got burst. Pikachu's in this moment.
I know. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Pikachu just builds me. Going for that two ice base. Hey, I don't know why she was lost there. Holding a little meter that she doesn't need.
Yeah, I was going to say.
It's just kind of a force of a habit kind of deal.
Better shoot him turns face like a snap camera or something.
Just kind of looking for the opportunity to get out of here. He doesn't really want to stay there.
So oh,
he had a call coming in through on that nuzzle. Okay, there it is. He wants to use Burst as a close the game kind of tool instead of just taking the damage.
Ooh, dang, okay.
There it is. Dora popping her Burst in response.
And she's gonna be careful with those 5-A's because that Electro can easily hunt it.
Oh no!
Still living though.
Yeah, still living.
It's anyone's game.
Oh,
there
okay.
It is. There it is.
Clip it.
Please tell me you guys gotta clip this. They both get a game.
So it's 2-1 now, guys.
Oh my gosh.
My goodness.
We're good at this.
This game.
Huh?
This game.
They both won, but also both lost. It's true.
It's...
Yeah, because you're trying to switch character, I take it?
I'm sorry.
Huh?
Is this the first draw we've had in basketball?
I say they should be both allowed to be changed characters.
Yeah, because it's such a gray area that's hard to tell. So yeah, it's fine. You guys both won and both lost at the same time, so it's just kind of like, okay.
Who's your Pokemon? So,
the word of law says you can change both characters. Assist and support.
Nice. Connor got a really good picture of him.
Appreciate it, Sully. Thank you. Alright, so let's see what we got here. Gengar. I'm not sure how this is going to work.
We'll see. He stuck to the scissor the entire time last month, if I recall correctly.
He did, but Gengar, I'm not too sure about this versus Pikachu, because I do believe that it is rather volatile.
Yeah.
Low health pool and the lack of meter to contest is a problem. However, he does have Jirachi to compensate for it some, and he is getting that. Right, send that face down, getting those sludge bombs, catching that flyback, get that astonish, good stuff. He's gonna go to the wall and he's gonna finish it. Yeah, he's gonna finish that dinner, get that meter. Wait, lit ball.
Dang. Unfortunately, it did not work out. Oh my gosh!
Those Shadow Sneaks coming in handy. Dior might not have a matchup experience to deal with this, but Pikachu.
It's a high potential.
Spud has a full meter already. Got him. Pikachu down with the Shadow Ball. Incredible. Setting that space down, just kind of like keeping the space control in front of us. Remember that when he hears the grab, gotta watch out for the timing on that thing.
Well, it's so hard to tell. I mean, yeah, the Shadow Ball disappears when they go for the grab, but man, it's so freaking fast that it's just like,
oh yeah. Sometimes it's just better to take the Shadow Ball instead because it'll take you like once or twice, but they can't really convert off of it, you know? Whereas if you take a grab, that's really powerful for Gengar because even Nizu, your Spud will, when he sees that you have full burst or hear it, it'll go straight for that grab.
Really good confirm there from Dior though.
Ooh, alright, whiff punish that nuzzle with the homing attack.
Popplio.
The attack buff, the double the double jump. We have movement in spades right now.
Alright, now that's going to be...
Right, yeah, that's going to be fun to do.
Because he's going to come in with anti-airs. Granted, the bomb is gone. But...
Go! 2x bomb? Okay. Alright, jump back laser though. Use the conversion. He's just going to...
No.
Damn it.
Alright, Spud taking it 3-1.
Somewhere, a Shulk player is being...